The Matte Refine node is an extension to Silhouette's other AI-powered auto matting solutions. It creates a natural edge from a hard matte, giving us fine detail with semi-transparency. It's perfect for hair, fur, feathers, or just enhancing any irregular edge. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris FX, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can take a hard edge matte created by something like Matte Assist ML and then polish it up using Matte Refine ML. Let's take a look at our first shot now. So I am going to cut out our main actress here using our Matte Assist ML. So if I come into the AI ML category, I'm just going to start along with Matte Assist. So this is a slightly different workflow if you've been working with something like Silhouette 2024, for example. Now, as we know, Matte Assist ML is the node we would use to propagate a matte across the entire shot. So if we take a look in the node parameters now, we have handy buttons for how we generate up that initial matte or the initial reference. So I'm going to click on Mask ML and it will connect everything up for me. So if I just double click on Mask ML, I can come in and let's create up this. So one on the head, one down the bottom of the body, and that's going to give us our main mask. Let's right click to create a red dot to get rid of any unwanted stuff. And what I'll also do is I'll create another reference frame on my final frame and on my first frame. So if I'm selecting humans, I always start with the head and then take something quite close down to the bottom of the screen. Looks like I need to clean that up just a little bit as well. So with our initial alpha established, double click to come into the Matte Assist and let's just play that through. And we can see that's giving me quite a nice hard edge matte. Let's look at this over gray. And we can see it's especially prevalent in the hair. Definitely not good enough for finished work. Okay, after this, I am going to just add in a cache node. I think because I'm going to be playing around with this quite a bit, let's just cache the frames in so it doesn't have to calculate these again and again. I'll just come midway through the shot and let's take a look at the Matte Refine ML node. And immediately as I place that on, you can see a difference in the quality of the hair. So let's turn it off and on. And we'll take a look down in the node parameters. You'll see we have several different models to choose from. We'll discuss all these in a little bit. Don't worry about that. Let's play that back. And as we look at the results here, are they perfect? Well, no, I mean, not entirely. We can spot little problems here and there. But for the amount of work we've put in so far, in just a couple of minutes, I think this is a really great starting point. Of course, we are going to make this better as well. What we can do in the rest of the tutorial is dive a little bit deeper into the parameters inside of Matte Refine. But more importantly, I'm going to show you a few little recipes that we can start to build up with some of the other nodes as well. Let's take a look at our second shot now. And I've already done the Mask ML and Matte Assist to generate up our hard edge matte. We can definitely see that in the hair. All right, so let's come in again, Matte Refine ML, bring that in. And I'll just use the one and two keys just to flip between the input and the output. Now, the model choice determines a few things, not just the output that we get. So the sharper model produces a sharper edge with fewer gray tones. Now, this may result in subtle details disappearing on individual frames, as we can sort of see in this example. But if you have fast moving imagery, it probably won't be noticeable. But for smaller movements, as we see here, it can be a little bit distracting. So for this particular shot, if all I was taking out was the Matte Refine mask, I maybe wouldn't choose this particular model. Let's change the model now to softer. You'll notice the edge grow disappears. And without any other changes, let's just play this back. The softer model keeps more of these gray tones in. We're still seeing a little bit of strobing, but again, if this was a faster moving shot, you know, it wouldn't be as visible. There's also a couple of little artifacts popping outside of the screen, but it's easy to use paint or roto just to clean those up. And they're usually well outside of the main area that we're focused on, so we don't run the risk of having to work with any sort of subtlety towards the edge. If I change my model now to video matting, and I'll play this through. Video matting is well suited to working with slower moving footage, like in this example. This is designed more around keeping temporal consistency. Looking at the fine hair detail, we don't have that same sort of strobing as we had in the previous models. The eagle-eyed of you may have noticed some holes happening inside the mat. Don't worry, this is expected and a really easy fix, which we'll do in just a moment. Because with matte refine models, I know that the core of the matte is good from matte assist. I'm really mainly focused on the edge details. Okay, so let's fill in those holes, shall we? Now I'm going to add in a matte repair node, but instead of placing that downstream of matte refine, I'm going to take it from the matte assist. And I'm just going to shrink, using shrink and grow, just going to shrink my mat in. And now this is our sort of core mat. And let's add these two together. So I'm going to use alpha composite, mat repair into input one, mat refine into input two. I'll come back into the mat repair controls and just adjust that a little bit so we find the right edge there. And that's a nice balance between keeping in the hair detail, keeping the temporal consistency, and having a nice matte still. Inside of Matte Refine ML, we do have things like the ability to shrink and grow, blur the edge, and do black clip and white clip. But for more fine controls, building up something like this is usually a bit better. And if you don't want to handcraft this each time, check out Compound Node. So it's an easy way of creating custom nodes out of multiple individual nodes, and we've got a video for that which I will link down below. Now if we look a little bit closer, we are getting background colors coming through the semi-transparent areas in the hair. We might not want that when we are comping stuff back over the top. Stay with me until the end and I'll show you a very quick trick about how to fix that and get your hair color back. Now speaking of hair, is this going to be a complete replacement for Hair Roto? I'm going to say probably not. Like any AI-powered solution, we shouldn't be thinking of this in the same way as we do Roto. We should think a bit more sort of procedural technique, like a Kia, a sort of more advanced Kia. If your original plate is challenging, say for lighting, noise, any of those sorts of issues, then the resultant key is going to be also quite problematic. If you need consistent subpixel accuracy in your shot, you know, there really is no other proper substitute for actual Roto. If we look at this work in progress, you can see we already have many, many individual strands that we are moving and animating to get, you know, 1/16th of a pixel accuracy that is consistent over time. But if you need a quick result that doesn't need that level of accuracy, then Matte Refine takes you a long, long way. Okay, as a final bonus, let's take a look at how we bring back the color into semi-transparent pixels. So here's our shot. I've already done the matte refine. Over on the other branch, I have a blurred and smoky version. And let's just look at what this matte refine looks like over gray. You can see loads of color bleed coming through from the graffiti and from the grass and just from the background. Or we'll composite this over the original shot. We can kind of almost maybe get away with it at speed, but you know, it does sort of make the edges look a little bit harsh and a little bit, well, unpleasant really. And there's one node that is going to fix loads of these problems. So after the matte refine, I'm going to add in a color estimation node. Let's take a look at the before and after. So without color estimation, with color estimation. And if I check out what this is doing over the RGB straight, you can see wherever we have semi-transparent pixels, it's coming in, filling those areas in from the other background, expanding those out. Taking this same frame here, we don't have that horrible edge we get if we had the color estimation turned off. We're getting much more sort of consistent colors coming through. Lovely, thicker, better hair with one color estimation node. So if you have any other questions about matte refine ML, mask ML, or any of our auto matting solutions, drop them in the comments below. If you want to give this a test drive for yourself, head over to borisfx.com and you can download a free trial. And of course, if you have an active subscription or upgrade plan, you can already download this straight today. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris FX. I'll see you again soon.